Emergency department overcrowding is a significant concern across the United States. Every year in this country of a population of 320 million people, there are over 136 million emergency department visits. Each year, this number of emergency department visits increases, while the number of available beds actually decreases, increasing wait times, increasing the chance for disability and death. My health services research investigates a reality that can directly impact emergency department overcrowding: care for alcohol intoxication. Did you know that up to 40% of people in the emergency department are intoxicated on alcohol? Majority of those in the emergency department who may have only alcohol intoxication and no other medical need cost the healthcare system over $900 million annually. And with those who don't need the advanced, comprehensive level of care in the emergency department, many cities and counties have created a service that can more appropriately care for those who are intoxicated: sobering centers. So what is a sobering center? It's like the urgent care for alcohol. Clients are provided a bed to rest in, vital sign monitoring, food, electrolytes, and are given what emergency departments just don't have enough of: time. There are about 20 sobering centers across this country, and dozens more cities and counties looking to initiate sobering programs. Yet there's absolutely no research on sobering programs on either their safety or their cost efficiency. My health services research investigates the San Francisco Sobering Center, a nurse-led program initiated in 2003 through the collaboration of over 50 local stakeholders. In the 8 years of analysis, there are over 30,000 encounters at this sobering center, brought in by the police, ambulances, emergency departments, or outreach workers. Importantly, 11,000 of these encounters were brought in by ambulance, directly impacting ED overcrowding. Looking at how the operations go, majority of these individuals were able to sober safely without any additional intervention, while less than 4% of people had a higher medical or psychiatric need requiring transfer to the department. The cost savings for this service is significant. My comparative analysis to San Francisco General Hospital found that the sobering center costs less than half that of the ED. Looking at just the individuals who came in via the ambulance, this small 12-bed sobering center saved the system over $3.5 million in just those 8 years. Alcohol intoxication is not going away anytime soon. This once first-of-its-kind research has been able to show that sobering centers can be a safe, cost-efficient alternative to the emergency department and is influencing health policy across the country. Importantly, we're also looking at the population of individuals who use the sobering center and the emergency department for intoxication to help develop programs across the country that can more appropriately care for those with public intoxication. Thank you.